So there's some timeless energy going on here after a separation where someone was trying to renew something with you but failed. This is someone who is hard on the outside but soft on the inside, wanting to reach out and communicate with you. I feel there could be a change in someone's energy, or there could be a change in someone's finances or someone's number. Please take it how it resonates with your message. But someone is being rebellious or really strife when it comes to you at a distance, trying to pretend they don't really care. This energy is being very inconspicuous, even though they're completely amazed by you. I feel like this is someone who overindulged within a situation and they were not present when it comes to the heart. They moved really quickly, impulsively when it comes to another situation that they didn't prepare themselves in. I feel like this is someone who tested the limit, who now wants to resurface. Resurface and build. Someone is opening a door or leaving the door open for you, but I feel the way they're trying to get your attention just might leave you shocked or disappointed. I feel like there's a lot of mixed signals when dealing with this energy who is hard on the outside but soft on the inside. This energy wants to renew something with you but has failed to do something because they have yet to reach out. I feel them not reaching out is helping you heal, helping you see something for what it is. Yet this energy is being very inconspicuous about their energy. Wanting you to stay but not being vocal about it. Where it seems they are feeling like you have some type of leverage when it comes to their energy. There is some pushback when it comes to the energy between the two of you. There could be others plotting against you or keeping the two of you apart when it comes to a renewal. Because someone is not telling the truth. Someone's not keeping it real. This is why there's some pushback when it comes to the leverage in a situation, and someone is avoiding the truth, which is not only causing them to be a little emotional, they could be lashing out when it comes to you. I feel this energy is not only lashing out at you, but also lashing out at others. Now that they see that you are unbothered or finding your way or closure or even your peace, someone is still not being real with themselves. Someone knows that you have receipts. You have the upper hand in a situation where they were inconsistent or flaky, leaving more questions than answers when it comes to their motives. But many of you are understanding how many people or what something really is. Wow. This energy is paranoid at what you know or the peace that you have found without them. This energy is wanting to make an impact, but as I said before, this energy is going to do it in a very distracted or very toxic way. As this energy has been so inconsistent and flaky with you, this energy really doesn't know how to get your attention without causing some type of drama or disdain, where they want to put you in a situation where you fight for your position or fight to tell the truth. But I feel many of you are finding a peace of mind where it's making them more paranoid than usual. So it seems like this energy is trying to be unbothered, but they're really down in the dumps, not in a good headspace because they can't cover something up. This is why they're being flaky and inconsistent, unreliable, because they're not being reasonable. I feel this energy was misinformed about something. This is what they're thinking about. I feel something random or a person, a situation that is random is going to cause them to flip-flop, change their point of view. And do something unexpected to test the waters with you. This energy wants to reboot something, but they're telling a lot of lies here. Trying to flip up on some energy here. This energy is going to put themselves in a position that they didn't expect. Trying to change, but this change is coming unexpectedly because of an impact or a tower moment. I feel this is someone who is pretending to be unbothered within a situation where the pieces are not put together. I feel there's a lot of curiosity where something unexpected is bound to happen. For someone who sold you out looking for a pot of gold, this energy is very nervous about the layers to a situation. They're wanting to test the waters and reboot something, but someone is not telling a full truth about something that is random. Relocating, someone quitting a job, someone being fired, or a destruction within a friendship or a family. I feel like this is someone who is acting like they're not interested, but this energy is all about you or thinking about you constantly. lost love, that they're wanting to pick something up with. This energy is wanting you to pick up the scent or be online thinking about the rumors or trying to reach out to them because they're trying to reach out to you, wanting to take a gamble when it comes to a cheating heart. There's different goals between the two of you. There's a lot of time has passed for some of you, and this is why there's a slow progress, because the two of you are moving in different directions. You are ride or die energy, and this energy is coming out as unsure and a failure to launch. Someone who doesn't have any bright ideas when it comes to being mesmerized by your energy. They're overwhelmed and still not sitting in the present, still moving, having no goals. This is why something is not moving for them. Wishy-washy energy of someone who is willing to rebuild and resurface. And this is why the door is still open when it comes to you. This energy is coming out as the great pretender, someone who allowed something or someone else to destroy the connection. Now they can't pick up a scent or understand where you're at right now to even contact you or get things right with you. This is someone who never fixed things in the past. They always relied on you to do so. But now they're nervous. This is someone who is all in their head about relocating or dropping the mask when it comes to a third party that was random. There's layers to this. So I definitely feel like there is multiple factors when it comes to this energy. He was wanting to test the waters, but they're still trying to cover up something that they were unbothered about until something very unexpected happened here. This is someone who is definitely in their head, down in the dumps, wanting to make an impact when it comes to flip-flopping on you, changing on you, doing something that is now causing them to be very paranoid about covering something up. Someone wants to know what you know. And for many of you, this energy just doesn't seem right. There's levels or layers to a situation that they're trying to cover up. This energy is trying to figure something out when it comes to getting your attention, switching something up, finding some way to reach out to you. But I feel something is about to happen that causes them to do something random when it comes to their fear and love, or even their fear of rejection. I feel like this energy definitely wants to make an impact when it comes to how they changed on you, how they switched up, how they became someone you used to know. This energy definitely took the easy way out. Now they could be suffering in silence, overthinking a situation that's definitely causing them to be miserable. Miserable, stuck in their head, still not seeing something clearly. This is what's caging them in and causing them to overthink in a situation that's keeping them suffering in their own misery. This is a lost soul that's living a nightmare. This is someone who is emotionally unavailable, an emotional wreck because of their hidden desires or doubts. There's a lot of secrets. This is why they're suffering in silence and living this night terror of misery that's causing them to be emotionally unavailable and exhausted. This is someone who neglects you because they have neglected themselves. This is someone who is sitting in mindless energy and it's taking them nowhere. This is why they're caught in their head. This is why they're caught in their thoughts. This is why they're keeping secrets and lies that are keeping something without closure or without cause. This is someone who is very codependent. There's a lot of real regrets. A lot of real regrets when it comes to someone who is very neglectful when it comes to life, love, and even you. As this is someone who is always trying to escape, but never having any direction, leaving themselves as well as anyone who tries to love them completely exhausted. This energy is miserable and living a lie, but since they've had some type of change of heart, they're wanting to refocus and gain some type of clarity, but there's too much anger, rage, and resentment. Even though they have seen something clearly, they're still a train wreck. This energy is a train wreck, even though they've had a change of heart. There's a lot of anger, rage, and resentment when it comes to their energy. Them living a lie has gone on for so long, a lot has changed about their energy. I feel this is someone who made you wait, and now they're completely distorted, losing self. and needing to go to through a stage of healing. This is a soul birth or a soul death to have a rebirth. But until then, this two-faced energy is going to feel empty while they go through this nightmare. Something is lurking when it comes to their energy. Someone needs to be focused, but this energy is still speaking lies and still not accepting the truth, even though they know they're sitting in regret. This is someone who's just not being real with self, not ready to do so. This is why they're coming out as Mr. Crab, someone who is hard on the outside, but soft on the inside. This is someone who wants to send some type of SOS, wanting to reach out, wanting you to be worried. But I feel many of you have chosen to move on because of this waiting game. Many of you have definitely compromised when dealing with this energy. You knew this person was an emotional wreck or likes to use their emotions to control the situation. But I feel there's healing, a soul birth, where someone is completely exhausted. This is your energy as well. Someone has definitely changed on you in many ways, but I feel this is someone who's just going through an impactful season where things are changing in their life in a very dark way. As it seems, this energy is still thinking and talking about you, but still not leveling up in any way. Lost, still an emotional wreck, and about to do something out of emotion unexpectedly. There's a lot of betrayal when dealing with this third-party energy or a false environment that is wearing a mask as well. There is no remorse, there is no sorrow, because they are living a lie. There's trust issues, and as I said before, things are a train wreck because this energy is full of rage, resentment for the path they chose. But this energy hasn't changed at all. Even though they've had a change of heart, this energy still has a lot of codependent ways and addictions, still trying to escape their own reality. This is why it feels like a waiting game with someone who is completely distorted, because they have lost so much of themselves through this mindless way of thinking, where they have had no direction, causing them to be two-faced as they live this nightmare, growing emptier day by day, neglecting self because of this third-party energy. This is why they're suffering in silence. This third-party energy has definitely stabbed them in the back as well. This is why there's a lot of confusion and chaos. This energy doesn't know whether to love or hate you. This is why things are more complex and complicated than it needs to be, as this energy is now wearing you as a heavy burden, because this energy is either talking good about you or bad about you. But there's a lot of talk about you. They can't avoid it. This is what makes things complex too, because they don't know how to feel about you. So confused when it comes to how they feel. It's just almost like a situation of Jekyll and Hyde, or someone who has created a thin line. Wow. A thin line between love and hate with you, because they struggle with self, who they want to be, who they should be. But I feel they are stuck in this space of emotional void, because this energy is closed off. Closed off to their hardened heart or naked truth or their rebellious ways. This is someone who is trying to master, manipulate a situation, not communicating, not being truthful or telling the truth about a situation. This energy was telling complete lies to manipulate something. Now those lies have become a heavy burden that has only caused more chaos and confusion, and something that was already distorted. Now something is a big mistake for someone who couldn't see something for what it was. They couldn't find themselves. They couldn't be vulnerable. Now there's a lot of heartbreak, rumors, and gossip, uncontrollable sweating for someone who is ashamed and hiding from guilt, hiding from the fact that they were fake, phony, false when it comes to a third party or karmic ties that they ghosted or silenced themselves for. This is someone who was telling a lot of lies or believing a lot of lies, causing a soul contract to be broken when they gave into karmic ties, breaking promises with childish mind games. I feel this energy played themselves by trying to play you, as these karmic soul ties definitely took them in the wrong direction, where now I feel there's a lot of detachment, there's silence, someone cut the cord because someone was sitting in a space of denial. a breaking point when it comes to insecurities and karmic ties. There's some trauma from the past that's caused someone to be real selfish and greedy. This is why there's a lack of respect. This is why someone changed on you, and this is why their life is a complete train wreck. This is someone who is living a complete lie just to deal with their own misery, but I feel they have night terrors. They can't sleep at night because they're trying to deal with this regret. This is someone who is trying to hide from the embarrassment of not communicating with you, keeping it real, or telling the naked truth about a karmic tie or a third party, something that they got completely lost in, because now they're tired of living a lie. They're tired of the mask. They know they could be real with themselves, with you, but this energy thought that they were missing out, and this is why they caused this betrayal. I feel this is someone who is completely exhausted and trying to be silent, but this energy is still getting into the gossip and the false statements made about you. I feel someone is also fanning the flames, wanting something to be done with you. They want someone to see you differently. Please take it how it resonates, reverse the roles if necessary, but someone, this third party is coming out in the reverse. Wow. Let's grab another deck here. Of course, if you guys are enjoying the reading, let me know by commenting down below or liking this video. But this third party is coming out in the reverse as I kind of try to figure out who's the mastermind here. But this third party is definitely hiding some secrets when it comes to this separation with you, keeping this other energy in doubt, causing them to have trust issues or see you in a bad light. I also feel there could be talk about you to keep something distorted, with them trying to cause you pain only brings them more misery. Someone definitely lost their way here. A lost romance. Someone feared intimacy. Someone didn't want someone else to know how deep they felt for you. I feel this third party is coming out as a puppet master. Someone who created an illusion in a very false situation caused something to switch up. There's a lot of doubt when it comes to healing. Someone can't heal. This energy is coming out as a lost soul, and this is why they're still talking negatively about you. But I feel someone is also checking them in that aspect because no one else is believing their lies. I feel someone could be in the early stages of getting something right and wanting to make an impact, but they feel like you're better off without them, or you just don't see them the same. As many of you have lost a lot of respect on how this third party was able to control them. I feel this could be a turning point here where there's a lot of gossip in a situation where someone was prepared to do something at all costs, causing misery within a home, and I feel the innocence was also affected. Someone was clinging to a situation or a wild heart. Now there's financial issues that's causing something to be hot and cold, and something is starting to sting when it comes to the past and even their foundation. Wow. Someone is definitely wanting to reach out in silence, but I feel something is going on when it comes to finances or stability that's causing a painful ending when it comes to a very manipulative female energy. This is someone who is hiding because of the third-party energy. They need to heal from this, but this energy is feeling safer in solitude, yet still watching you. Still watching, knowing that you are waiting for an apology, but things are just not going to go their way. The time is coming out in the reverse, and they know the two of you are just not on the same page. And the fact that you guys are not on the same page is causing them to be very affected behind the scenes, not wanting to talk about you, or they're talking a lot about you just to keep from giving in to the pain. I feel this could be negative talk, so they don't give in to calling or reaching out to you or acknowledging what they have done, because they're just not on the same page when it comes to the pain that they have caused or being inconsistent with you. This energy still has a wild heart, possibly still fighting with you at all costs, even though they know they were wrong. It's just too many trust issues, and so instead of trying to apologize for what they've done because they're not strong enough to do so, this energy is trying to cause some type of misery through distance, silence, or even speaking of ill will about you. I feel this is someone who disappeared on you. This is a disappearing act for someone who has some deep wounds from the past. This is someone who is still blinded to their own guilt and still being destructive to their own life as well as those who choose to love them. This is someone who's very codependent, has trust issues, consumed by how things look, and this is why something can't be let go when it comes to being naive to loyalty or having an outdated way of thinking when it comes to projecting their own issues. This is someone who is never telling the truth. Never telling the truth, a pathological liar who is projecting what they truly feel because they're disconnected to wasting time, disconnected from their heart, or the fact that they're never satisfied, always on the defense. Always on the defense when it comes to projection and telling lies and wasting time with influences. But I feel this is someone who's about to be triggered when it comes to being blocked out from you. Because it's only bringing them stress. They can't be in this defensive mode for too long because it's causing them to be delusional when it comes to things that are meant to be. But this energy is so disconnected from their lives. They're too dark, too confused to realize they're a snake in the grass, someone who acts innocent but will truly hurt you. This is someone who is still testing the vibe or testing the boundaries with you because of their insecure ways, not fully wanting to come in head on, full force. But I feel this is someone who is starting to feel unloved as the things in their mind start to replay on how they truly hurt you for no reason. This is someone who took too long to reach out, took too long to commit, and their patterns of behaviors just continue to go on and on. This is how they wasted so much time worried about what others think, worried about how things really was, and this is how they lost financially, spiritually, and mentally. I feel this is someone who is now realizing how much this third party likes to talk or how much this third party likes to start drama. This is why this energy disappeared. I feel this energy is also trying to speak in ways where others don't see that they're weak or stressed out. This is why they're always on defense about you and even life. But this energy is in the dumps, in a very dark headspace, and sitting in their own misery, trying to appear hard, but they know they're weak. This is why they're trying to make you the victim in their life story. Wow. I feel like this energy is trying to make you the villain in their life story because they are too caught up in self to see the truth. Pathological liar, someone who is never telling the truth and always willing to be in defense on disappearing from others or leaving something in question. I feel this is someone who is now stressed out because their delusions are now keeping them stressed out. And the more stressed out they become, the more confused they seem to be about you. I feel this is someone who is caught in a state of delusion because of their codependent ways or their childish ways. There could also be innocent energy here who is also going through a painful transformation, all because of a third-party puppet master energy or even some gossip. I feel this is someone who is overly aggressive about what they're going through and the lies that they have told, but this energy is coming out as someone who is full of drama. Someone who is driven by their weaknesses and the fact that they feel abandoned by you, left behind. But I feel this energy is truly going through a dark night of the soul. I feel this is someone who gave up, no fight. Now they're depressed about it because someone thought that you were fixes. But I feel this is someone who moved impulsively down a very dark path and now they don't know who they are, hiding behind a mask. I feel this is someone who is stuck behind a false way of being and they're faking their happiness, consumed by their own emotions and influences. This energy is being very forceful when it comes to orchestrating something that is still folding or falling apart. I feel this is someone who is trying to fill a void that they're very empty about. They're keeping secrets when it comes to a dark attachment, and they're still playing the martyr, the victim. Still not seeing something for what it is because it's too hard to admit their wrongs. I feel this is someone who is still talking, knowing their trap played out because something is faded out because of their immature ways. Someone is playing hide and seek with you and cause a lot of distance because they are playing the victim. Now this energy is getting caught up in their lies, pretending that they don't see a truth. Someone is now triggered because you're no longer triggered about them, that which is causing them to go to the edge on something, feeling like they're being pushed to the edge emotionally. Now this energy is acting like a serious fool. Someone knows they clown themselves, that they're over emotional or overwhelmed by this hide and seek game that caused something to fade out, because now they're attached to something that is dark and bitter. This energy is salty at the fact that you were not a pushover and you just didn't let them back in. This is someone who has a lot of trust issues now. Whatever you had before, they've completely changed in the worst way. They're still trying to orchestrate something, trying to pretend to be hard when they know they're not. This is someone who's trying to keep up with appearances, even though they're very destructive with their tendencies. You're still not on the same page. The time is coming out in the reverse, as this energy is still repeating patterns with their insecurities and lurking in the dark. I feel this is someone who looked down on you at some period, caused a lot of stress when it comes to affairs of the heart because they're hiding their true motives. But I feel this is someone who was seeking attention from others with snake-like energy as well. And this is what causing them to be in the energy of feeling unloved or like a loser, because now they're feeling blocked out. This energy feels like you will always see them as a snake or someone who has betrayed you. This energy feels like you won't let them back in, so they're just fine with stressing you out, orchestrating something from behind the scenes, because they're definitely hiding from you. This energy doesn't want to see you face to face. This energy doesn't want to see you face to face because you know that they know that you'll see right through them. But many of you don't have time for their petty games anymore. You just have time to heal. I feel many of you have had to move on, let this person live to really find out. But I feel this is someone who is already understanding what they have lost. They just have no clue how to make things right or even find a way to get your attention. As I said before, this energy is willing to do something in a harsh way or a positive way. It doesn't really matter how they get their attention. They just have to know they can still do so. I feel this is someone who is trying to orchestrate something that's going to cause a lot of drama. This energy is wanting to provoke you emotionally. They want you to lash out. They want you to defend yourself. Someone wants you to be stressed and on the defense when it comes to someone giving a truth or something about the drama when it comes to influences. But this energy is going through a dark night of the soul, and the stress they have caused will be the only way they'll be able to fight their way out of this way of a wild heart, these dark attachments that caused something to fade because they couldn't be tamed. Let's get another deck here. This is someone who is full of drama, causing a lot of pain, causing a lot of unfinished business. Many of you feel like this energy should just get lost because they didn't put up a fight then. You have no interest now. Someone wants to be casual and take something slow because they know how they gave up was carelessly done or overly done. Someone knows they took something too far with you because they were trying to give in to attachments, fit into a situation, or give in to a wild heart, causing something to be unfinished. Now they're wanting to have good intentions when it comes to you. Someone is wanting to be casual about telling you something or admitting something to you, but I feel it would only be a half-truth because this energy is still attracted to the drama and still attached to something that is dark. But I feel this is someone who is so uncertain about something, they're going to make some false promises when it comes to this relationship because they feel like you're picky. This energy feels like you're picky and independent, and they don't know how to do something without breadcrumbing you. Someone is wanting to breadcrumb you, give you a direct message, or come through unexpectedly and reconcile something with you. This is someone who wants to make some type of offer because they're starting to feel lonely with their player ways. But I feel many of you just see them as a snake or someone who pretends to be innocent. But I feel this energy is going to come in love bombing you, trying to be playful with you, because they want another chance with you. Same energy thinks about texting all the time, being a friend again, talking again, but this energy is wanting you to open up, wanting you to believe they are true love, but this energy still has fuckboy energy. Please reverse the roles if necessary. This could be feminine as well. But I feel this is someone who is still attached to some gossip, or this energy has some very gossipy ways when it comes to you, because something is still immature, or someone is still immature when it comes to a situation that is about to step forward in divine timing. I feel this could be in a space where you have found a sense of peace or a sense of grace, but I feel this is going to bring up a lot of feelings that you thought were done or over. I feel this is someone who knows they made a lot of mistakes when it comes to their fear of commitment, but for many of you, you just think things will never change, so you don't put in the same effort as you used to. I feel like this energy kind of wants others to think that you're the issue here. I feel like this is someone who believes you're doing the most, wants others to believe this about you. But I feel this is someone who is only causing more problems than they're wanting to admit to. But I feel their fear of commitment is causing them to make so many mistakes. They're not being honest about how they ignored you. Someone's not being honest about how they ignored you or tried to make you wait or chase. This is someone who didn't validate what they had with you or validate how you felt about a situation or even your concerns. They just ghosted you. This energy just took off with no real reason. And I feel even during a talking phase, this energy pretended you were the problem. They ignored your emotions, your thoughts, your concerns. And now that you are closed off, this energy is regretting their bad intentions. This energy is coming out as a narcissist. Someone who is under attack or under judgment when it comes to you, or they're just upset about the fact that they're blocked or you're no longer reaching out the way you used to. This energy feels like you intimidate them. This energy wants to know what you're doing. They're curious, wanting to reach out, but they're intimidated by you, shocked at the fact that you blocked them for their disrespect. This is someone who feels like you're not interested. That is also very intimidating to them, because now they're having to force something with someone, and they're really not interested in them the way they're interested in you. But the fact that you are intimidating is starting to drive them crazy. Someone thought that you would be the one who would be losing their mind, but it's them. This energy is feeling the fear of it, but not wanting to beg for it. This energy doesn't want to feel weak. This is why they're gaslighting you and dealing with this situation shift. This energy is forcing something that's driving them crazy, and now this is driving them to reach out, pretend it's a misunderstanding, wanting to meet up. But this energy is not wanting to tell you they're sorry. This energy is just wanting to trauma bond with you. This energy is wanting to deflect when it comes to the details, but still not give in to the pain of the drama. This energy is not admitting that they are sorry, but they're admitting there's trauma. This energy wants to admit that there's trauma in the bond, but they won't admit that they're sorry. This energy is still invested in friends. There's something unexpected they're dealing with, and they're kind of obsessed with a vibe. They're obsessed with the vibe that you had. They still have love for you. This is someone who really threw something away, who now wants to hang out, but they still have some shady ways when it comes to their depression or the fact that they are still not appreciating you, because they're uncertain about self. This is why they're going to make these false promises when it comes to this relationship or bond, because they know that you are picky, that you deserve the best, or you want your respect. Someone is definitely in a space where they're all in their head about how they ignored you. They could be speaking lies when it comes to how they abandoned a situation, or they gave in to their friends, or they just didn't apologize to you. I feel this is someone who knows that they owe you respect. Someone owes you an apology. Someone owes you way more than what they have given. But this energy has been so lost in these dark attachments that they have yet to give in to their own regrets. They're just allowing things to fade out while they give in to this childish behavior or immature attitude, this energy just still hasn't grown up. This energy is still playing a fool. This energy is still making a lot of mistakes that they have yet to be healed from or even find any light from. This energy is still not learning any lessons from their mistakes or things that are undone, as they seem to be in a very immature vibe of thinking after all they have done or after all of this time, this energy is still not focusing on the real, as they shouldn't be thinking about what they think they've done for you, but more about what they've done to you. Yet the fact that all they can do is think about self is another reason why I feel they're about to expose some things about themselves that many of you already know. I feel this is someone who wants to meet up, but they've made up a lot of mistakes about how they were trying to drive you crazy or trying to provoke something out of you through gossip or distance or even silence. Now someone is down in the dumps and moving slowly because they know they have a lot of love for you, but not wanting to appear weak. Someone definitely has an anxious mind when it comes to you. There's a lot of regret when dealing with this energy. But due to the mistakes they have made in the past, it's hard for them to try to really admit anything because you're so intimidating. Something is very intimidating when it comes to you. For some of you, they feel like you emasculate them in some type of way that they can't be the person they need to be. But I feel it's only because these dark attachments that keeps them low vibrational and petty these days. I feel this is someone who was at their best with you. This is why they're intimidated by you, because you do not do anything to fail. This is someone who doesn't have the same push, the same morals, the same values as you do. And this is what's intimidating, not you. It was always the love that you gave that they know they couldn't give back that intimidated them. Which down the line, I feel this energy will come to realize it was their biggest mistake. A mistake that will turn into their biggest regret. I feel like this is someone who's about to expose something through their envious, childish ways. I feel this will be a big mistake that will cause someone to vanish or be left out. Whatever this mistake is will drive them crazy because you're looking good these days. I feel you're moving better or healing better without someone and their childish ways. And I feel they're also very anxious about their delusions, about how something really ended or caused delays and distractions. Someone is definitely trying to strategize when it comes to you. I feel like someone wants attention. They want spotlight energy. There's wishful thinking here, but many of you feel like so much has changed about life and even yourself. Something is definitely at a standstill because they refuse to release something, or they could still be looking for attention at night. I feel this is someone who is very theatrical. This is why things are coming out as codependent and delusional, as this energy is still putting on a show and being strategic when it comes to their betrayal. This energy is still living a false life. This is why their energy is coming out as up and down, highs and lows when it comes to someone who could be acting crazily when it comes to their weaknesses. Someone just allowed something with you to just slip away because of the lies they told, the secret that they wanted to keep, and the competition they put you in. Now something is a complete nightmare. Someone really can't sleep. This is why they are down in the dumps and doing strange things at night, because they're in a drought, wanting to escape something that was forbidden. This is someone who is on the edge, wanting to live a silent life. This is someone who comes out as a thorn in your side, who has hit a dead end. Someone has hit a dead end and they're on the edge, questioning everything because something has come to a harsh, painful ending. Something has hit a dead end. Someone is definitely feeling the pain of letting something go for something forbidden. Someone is regretting the fact that you slipped away because you're no longer amused by their charm, by their words, their energy. Someone is now being rebellious and living in the fast lane. This is someone who now has obligation, responsibilities, and they're thinking about all the wisdom or the talks that you once had, but they don't have the key to your heart this time because of their narrow way of thinking. This is someone who is not thinking from a clear space if they know they were not generous when it comes to you. I feel like this is someone who was not being authentic as you were, as it seems they only saw it as a means to an end to make you feel comfortable in a contract with many hidden terms, which may have had a long list of promises that they know they would never keep. I feel this is someone who had a very narrow way of thinking, but is still watching, wanting to escape the secrets that they have kept. But I feel this is someone who is lacking in remorse and regret, even though they know they are drawn to you and wanting to return to you. There's a lot of reflection, wanting to escape something that they feel is now urgent, but the fact that they are wanting the spotlight in something, this might be wishful thinking. I feel someone just may be wishing for more than they deserve these days. This is why things are harsh, or they feel like they're being driven crazy. Someone feels like you may be giving them tough love, or someone could be telling them that so that they can keep their hopes up. But this is someone who is completely anxious and still immature, as they're still trying to hold on to something that is keeping them dark and delusional. This is someone who has a lot of abandonment issues, whether this is childhood energy or someone just feeling that way now. But I feel the fact that you don't know who they are from these mistakes, this is what's keeping something distant because of their betrayals. These betrayals are definitely attached to someone who hurt you because they're also hurting. This is someone who is hurting from their mistakes and their losses, and this is why they don't know whether to love or to hate you. This energy has a lot of love, but the intimidation that they feel keeps them at a distance. Someone knows they made a lot of mistakes for their fear of commitment, and they know they tried to drive you crazy or drove you crazy, but the fact that they are now intimidated by the fact of coming in, this is why there is a lot of immature behavior in the process. There's a lot of immature energy when it comes to this person. This is why they're still giving into betrayals. They're lurking in the shadows. There could be some drama. So it seems there's a lot of immature behavior going on when it comes to their mistakes. They're still trying to justify their behaviors of something fading out. This is the sense of delusion where someone is very anxious of others finding out the truth because they're still codependent on something or someone that's keeping them lost or faded out. Someone could be keeping them in a space where they're intimidated by you, or they're just using this as an excuse. But I feel there's a lot of betrayal when it comes to those they choose to invest in. This could be a group of people or a karmic family or karmic ties, but I feel someone is failing to start over in a situation because they feel like you don't want to hear it. This is someone's karma for being for the streets. This is someone's karma for putting a false environment in front of you. This is someone's karma for trying to drive you crazy. This is someone's karma for playing games they knew they would never win. I feel there's a lot of family gossip. There's a lot of talk dealing with the karmic energy. There could also be justice playing out in their life in the form of karma, where they have lost a soulmate that is now driving them crazy because there's no closure. Someone didn't know that they would lose you this way. Someone is running out of time. They're closed off. They know they backstabbed you. And this is someone who was unfaithful and unloyal, and they were definitely leaving you on red when it comes to messages reaching out. But now you have risen above something. This is queen or king status for someone who is going in a different direction, and someone is feeling unstable when it comes to you. Unstable when it comes to their book of lies. Someone's just shutting down, keeping you waiting because they're still playing childish games. Well, someone is still playing childish games because they know that you won't let them explain or you won't hear them out. This is why they're leaving you on red, knowing they are shattering something, creating a toxic connection, because someone's not wanting to give in to their shame. Someone's not wanting to deal with the shame of trying to destroy you or cause some type of chaos verbally, putting you on blast, or causing others to see you in a very toxic way. These are also snake energies that they were talking to or investing in, where someone is now realizing they broke your heart, caused too much damage when it comes to a twin flame. Someone got caught having feelings are doing the most when it comes to a third party, because they were scared to love or connect with you. Someone gave into something that is now feeling like there was a lot of strings attached. Someone is definitely being secretive or sneaky when it comes to a karmic or a third party who is giving fake love. They're feeling empty when it comes to loyalty. They're walking on eggshells because they know they chose the wrong person. But now this energy is so stuck in their pride or their childish ways and addictions that they are still too comfortable to turn away this fake love. They know it's not real, but the fact that it's not real keeps them in a sense where they feel like they can detach at any time. But I feel it just won't be as easy to come back to you or get things right, because these are definitely bad influences that will disappoint them in time, because something just might be too little too late for the troubled one. Someone will get caught. Someone will bring bad news. I feel this will cause many of you to back off and step into your own light, your energy, while someone loses sleep over you. This is someone who is losing sleep in various ways. I feel this energy is yet to step into the frying pan when it comes to many of you dealing with influences and the fact that this energy is still blinded to a truth. Blinded to a truth. Because this energy being blinded to a truth is only causing things to be more complicated than it needs to be. Because they're hurting without you, knowing that you're not looking back. You're just moving on. Finding your peace, finding your space, finding a way to get over someone who never really took you seriously. I feel the more you distance yourself from this energy, the more they want to make amends. They want to know that they still have you bound emotionally to this history of this situation, but I feel they're starting to have an anxious mindset because things are turning out to be a little bit more difficult than they thought it would be. I feel like you've done something that has caused them to feel like things are different. Maybe you know more about the situation than they think. Someone is definitely stressed out about what you know. This energy is stressed out about what you know because they know they've done the most. As it seems, this energy truly has a sense of hatred for self, which always puts them in a position to easily hate or push anyone that really truly cares for them away. As it seems, they always tend to hurt the ones they love the most, which may be another reason why they have failed to change. As I sense, many are still speaking of you in a negative light because they're claiming you're the reason something failed. But I feel this is someone who was just not stepping into their life. But the fact that they were not stepping into their life, pretending that you were intimidating, this energy is now receiving karma that they will not forget. These mistakes are definitely bigger than them, and the anxiety that they are feeling during this delusion is the karma that's about to come their way through these dark attachments. This energy is about to learn some very valuable lessons for causing unnecessary problems, but I feel their anxiety and stress would be the least of their worries while they're claiming you were this or that. They fail to realize the way you actually held things together and made things work. Because their words and actions only caused things to fail because they were too scared to admit how you truly made them feel, how things were really actually working with you. But I feel this person having the fear of missing out caused them to want more than they needed. This energy just gave in to a dark way of being just to get a little attention that they now wish they never received. But I feel this is someone who is just being so immature about something. This energy is still not letting go of dark attachments that they know is keeping them lost and delusional. This energy is sitting in their pride, thinking that they are more of a woman or more of a man. Please take it how it resonates. But this energy feels like they are taking a stance. This energy doesn't want to seem weak, but I feel it caused them to be more weak and more vulnerable than they really want to admit. Because them giving up so easily or being defensive or giving up with no fight, I feel that hurt them more than they actually wanted to admit to. Their betrayals only ended up hurting them the most. Let's get some final energy here. Confirmation, Holy Spirit, what are the messages here? So someone is definitely thinking about the possibilities when it comes to your energy. Yet they're so immature, they're still not willing to speak up and admit that they still see you as a twin flame. I feel this is someone who will have to tell the truth, because they know that something was not ordinary with you. Someone really just thought that you would never let go, but something has changed when it comes to your energy, how you feel or what you think of them, especially after hearing what they have said or knowing the truth that you know. I feel this is someone who knows the truth will set them free, but this is someone who has given up in a way where they're just being overly aggressive about a situation, still not wanting to speak up, still just wanting you to let go, but it's only bringing them more karma in the long run. They're just prolonging the pain because they refuse the treatment. This is someone who knows they're going to have to earn your trust by starting from the bottom up, but this energy is still learning some karmic lessons when it comes to blocking out love. I feel this is someone who is still learning lessons when it comes to being curious or having a fear of missing out. Someone is now seeing the truth. Someone is now understanding what you meant when you spoke your words. These are words that they held against you. Now there's a sense of guilt because they didn't stop what they were doing. They just made something more complicated. They made the scars and the wounds run deep here. Now they're struggling to overcome some self-imposed beliefs, and they're reminiscing about the path that they chose, knowing they affected the good times through their fears and anxieties. They just feel like something is just going to be too much to get you to see them differently, but I feel this is the immature vibes that makes them feel like something is impossible, because it's just as simple as just being real and honest with you, opening up and being vulnerable, and really choosing not to make these decisions again. But this energy is living in fear and anxiety because of their poor decisions, because they're still not ready to step up and heal their chakra. This is someone who is still living in a false state of being because they're at a crossroads. This is a major intersection in their life where they're very caught up in their emotions. As I said before, this is someone who's coming out as an emotional train wreck, someone who is throwing themselves a pity party. This is someone who is still sitting in a comfort zone, yet I feel they're about to do something very unexpected when it comes to being powerless to their web of lies. This is someone who is going through a lot of karma here. I feel karma is at work when it comes to someone who is on the defense when it comes to their immature ways or web of lies, but I feel they're about to be powerless to something that is sacred, because they're still lurking in the shadows. Someone is about to deal with a heap of karma that they didn't expect, because someone is definitely not realizing time is not on their side. But the more they wait to build something with you and start their way from the bottom, change will come their way no matter what they want or what they feel they need, because they didn't fight for something and they just isolated themselves. Time just might be up when it comes to resolving something with you. Someone needs to be real about their choices, as it seems this is someone who has always played a lot of mind games and been very mindful about their manipulation when it comes to painting themselves as a victim to those who chose to entertain or feed into their stories, just to keep from being responsible or accountable for their wrongdoings, hoping others would believe you're holding them back or holding a grudge, when in fact you're just setting a lot of boundaries that are long overdue. Yet I sense the more losses they take, the more this energy seems to try to paint you as the villain or pretend like it's too much to create this new start with you. But I feel this person sitting in this space of not wanting to make things right will only cut them in the end, because this is someone who truly needed you. I feel this is someone who needed you but seems to blame you for everything. Every loss that they take, the more this energy seems to blame you, as it seems being accountable for their own actions feels more like an attack or a defeat for someone who is just not ready to own or acknowledge what they've done and what they've put you through. I feel this is someone who is refusing to see how they have changed, but I feel their immature ways will lead them to a space of revealing something as they go through a dark night of the soul with these dark attachments. There's a lot of karma here for someone who didn't keep something sacred. There's a lot of karma for someone who just gave up and didn't fight for this. And is now powerless to a twin flame or approaching something that they're at defense. Someone is on the defense, having an anxious mindset of what you may say or what you may do when it comes to them just giving up on you. I feel this is someone who's just trying to accept the truth, but they just didn't expect it to be a hard pill to swallow, as this is someone who definitely wants to resurrect something with you, because they feel like this shit ain't done. Somebody's feeling like it just can't end like this, but this is someone who's just not gained the tools or the know-how to fix something with you. They just keep reflecting on the good old times, but still not giving in to the respect that they know is long overdue. As this energy is still giving immature vibes when it comes to their space, their time, and their energy, they're full of anxiety and still full of drama because there's a lot of things that have yet to heal. I feel this is someone who is still not healing the obvious. I feel the scars run deep, and this is why this energy is trying to burn you or affect you in some type of way. But I also feel this is attached to something that has nothing to do with you, but you are clearly affected by it. I feel this energy has been very shallow, or they did a lot of things from an unexpected place because shit got real. Something happened where this person realized that something was not a game, as many of the things that they have done, they cannot overdo, just live with. Because the less they chose to respect or show love, the more silence or distance that was gained here. I feel like this is someone who caused a lot of trouble lashing out, rebelling, speaking things that they know was not true just to gain some type of attention or empathy from others. Just because they're refusing to admit or give in to the shame and the pain of what they've done. Someone really thinks they owe you something, but they also feel you owe them something. This is how they deflect. This is how they play the games that they choose to play. I feel like this is someone who is living in fear because they know they're believing their own lies. This is someone who is too comfortable, still thinking about the past, but still not making the change. I feel this is someone who has a lot of guilt from the past. This energy has a lot of deep wounds, and they're living in fear of things coming out. But I feel this is someone who's going to have to tap into a higher place to connect with you. Come out of this rebellious place of refusing to give in. Yet I sense when you stand in your word and stand in your boundaries, this is how a fool's supposed to feel when they lose the most important person that's been there from day one or always had their back. But I feel this energy never really took something serious. They gave up so easily because they felt like you would always be there, or you wouldn't take something so far. You would never let go in the way that you did. But I feel this energy was shocked. But I also feel this energy greatly disappointed you by the drama that they caused. I feel this is someone who gave into the anxiety of it all through their immature lies and their web of lies. But I feel this energy told a lot of lies that they can no longer stand by or deflect by, or someone's definitely poking holes in their story. And this is why someone is investing and thinking about what they've done, thinking that something has to be resurrected with you because they can't stand the lies. They feel like something is just not dead with you. Someone is definitely resisting self. As I said before in this reading, it's like Jekyll and Hyde. You really don't know what you're going to get with this energy, as it seems like they have a lot of love for you, but they also have a lot of hate. This is the resentment. This is the anger that they're still not healing or dealing with. They're struggling with who they are and who they should be, and this is why this energy is lost when it comes to you. still not understanding, still not giving in, still not ready to surrender, but this energy is wanting to. They believe in the love story that they have with you, but this energy is still defensive when it comes to their desires, their weaknesses, and giving up is just what they do. Final energy here, Holy Spirit. But as I said before, this is what a fool should feel when they've lost something so important for nothing. For nothing and nobody. For a very false situation where someone thought that your unconditional love was a misunderstanding as unconditional tolerance, causing many of you to lose interest. A lot of you lost interest in this situation. Someone's access was denied to be with you or be around you. Someone definitely lost a lot by playing games with you because they may never receive that energy again. As I sense, you're no longer giving them the benefit of the doubt, because the only thing that they are consistent in isn't loving you, not in the way that you should. This is someone who made it you wait. This is someone who did not give in to the connection. This is someone who was too embarrassed or too ashamed or too full of themselves to even see through what was told or what others were sharing or what others wanted them to believe. But I feel this energy pretended you owed them something. Something was missing. They want you to feel some type of way about walking away. But I feel the only thing that you owe them is your silence or your absence. Since the only thing they were consistent in was changing faces or even victims, but never themselves. I hope you guys have enjoyed the reading. And